Remember when we revolutionized classroom attendance with QR codes using Google Sheets and Forms? That was a game changer during the pandemic, but things have changed in the last few years. I heard your feedback about the system and have worked with hundreds of you to provide workarounds and customizations. So how about we go back to basics? That's exactly what we're going to do today, and stick around to the end to see how we can pull it all together in an easy to read format for your reporting. Let's start off with a new window. We'll open up Google Sheets and put in our student ID, first name and last name. Now, if you want it incredibly easy, all we need to do at the top is put in a date. Let's go with the 10th of July, 2023, and then just pop in some checkboxes. We'll click insert, checkbox. So on this date, we can just check who's present and we're good to go. But let's make it a little bit more complex to see who's present, who's absent, and who's late. So back in our window, we'll open up a new tab and we'll go to forms.new. Let's head back to our spreadsheet. Copy all of our names, Control-C to copy, and then back in our Google form, we'll start off with a title. Let's call it Daily Attendance. The first question here is going to be the date. It should automatically change for you. However, if it doesn't, like mine, we click on this dropdown and we go down to date. After that, if you have periods in your day or classes, you can put that into the next box. But if you don't have any periods, just leave that one blank, leave that one out, you don't need it. And then one more. This one will be names. We'll click on this button and you can choose between checkboxes or multiple choice grid. Checkboxes is pretty much exactly the same as what we did here, so that's a little bit redundant. So let's change this to multiple choice grid. Our rows is going to be our list of names. Now we already copied all of this, so let's paste that in there using Control V, and all of our names are now in this box. The columns are going to be present, late, and absent. We don't need a column 4, let's just delete that. So now when we view it, it looks like this. We have the date, the period, and then a present, late, and absent box for each person. So if we click these, they each change. Now let's just change it a little bit. So let's undo that. We'll give it a title at the top, Daily Attendance, and then down the bottom of this, we'll require a response in each row. I'll do the same for date, make that required, and period, make that required as well. So now when we click this I, we get this information here, everything is required, and we can go and do our attendance. So let's say that today's date is, actually let's do the date for yesterday, the 10th of July, and the period, let's go with first period. Let's do some absences and lates and all of that right here. Click on submit, and daily attendance has been recorded. If we look back here, we can see responses. We have one there, and there's the information down the bottom. If we click link to sheets, we'll select an existing spreadsheet, and we're going to use the one that we just created. Now, usually it should be the first one in the list. It's not actually there, so let's click on this one here. We have to find it. A good way to find it is to actually name it, which I didn't do. Let's call this daily attendance. But I know that that's this one here because of the checkboxes. So I'm going to double click that. It opens and there's our information. If we look on sheet one here, there's exactly what we created before. I'm going to go ahead and delete that column. We'll come back to it later. Now, if we look in the form responses here, this format is pretty terrible. We've got the timestamp of when the role was completed, when the attendance was completed. We've got the date, the period, but then we have all of this junk. What we really want is to have the attendance list vertical so we can really see what's going on, see who is late, present, and absent in just a quick glance. So let's head back to our sheet, and we're going to use sheet one down here for our data analysis. I'm just going to close this tab up the top because we don't need to duplicate that, and let's close this one as well. So in column D, I know I just deleted it, but let's call it the 10th of July 2023. And I actually want to fill out the next 7 days, 5 days if you really want, but I don't know if you have weekend school where you are. So a quick way to do that would be the sequence function. Now the sequence function takes in a few arguments. If we click this question mark box here, we can see it does rows first, then columns, then start and step. So the rows, how many rows do we want? We want one row. How many columns? Well, there's 7 days in a week, so let's put the number 7. You can use the number 5 if you don't want to include weekends. When do we want to start? Well, let's start the 10th of July 2023 in quotation marks, and the step is automatically going to be 1, so that's 1 day at a time, so we can just push that. There's our dates. These dates look a little bit funky, so I'm going to select all of them, go up to Format, Number, and then Date. Now they're a bit prettier. We're going from the 10th to the 16th of July. I'm going to center those, and I'm actually going to turn them on their side. Highlight all those, double click. That's a little bit too compact for my liking, so I'm just going to spread them out a bit and give them a bit more room. Now comes the formula. Now, this part's going to be a little bit complex, so stick with me. I'm going to walk you through it step by step so you can see how this is built, and I'm also going to leave a link to this file down in the description below just in case you're a little bit lost. So, let's jump into the formula. Now, let's walk through the logic. First, we need to find this person within this list of names, but also compare it to the right date, which is in column B. So the easiest thing that I can see is the student ID. Now it's important to have the student ID because there's cases all the time where you end up with students with the same first and last name. So let's use a student ID as their main identifier. First thing we'll do is a match function. We're going to look for this number here. Let's lock the A in place by pressing the F4 key. So we get $A2. Where are we going to look? Well, we're going to look in this section here, from here onwards. So I'm just going to select the first three and then backspace on the F. So we get D1 to 1. That selects the entire row. I'll press F4 to lock that in place, a comma, and then a zero. The zero at the end means we're looking for an exact match. Press Enter, and we get an NA. The reason for that is because we can't find 231010 anywhere in here. Even though we can see it here, the computer can't. The reason for that is it's surrounded by other text. We've got names and then this bracket and then the actual name afterwards. So we need to use a wildcard. So back in our formula, we'll start this with a star in double quotation marks and an ampersand. That means we don't care what the characters are before it, but there should be some. And then the same afterwards, we'll use an ampersand, double quotation marks, and a star. Press Enter, and we get the number 1. Now the number 1 just means it's in the first position of this horizontal list. Now I'm going to do something else here that might not make sense. I'm just going to change this from D1 to B1. So we're actually starting our search here, and we're searching across. And we'll get to why that is later. Let's go back to Sheet 1, and let's turn this into an array formula. So instead of just A2, let's search for A2 down to A. Hold Control, Shift, and Enter to give us that array formula at the start, and press Enter. That gives us a full list of numbers, which looks fine, but as we scroll down, we can see a bunch of ones, because it's looking for this, which is blank, in this list, and it can find it in the first cell. So let's start off with if A2 to A equals blank, then return nothing. Press Enter, and as we scroll down, there's nothing here, and the computer's not working so hard to find all of these blanks, thanks to that if statement. So now we know that Emily is in the third column, Michael's in the fourth column, and Renee is in the fifth column of this section here. Now we can use a VLOOKUP, that's right, VLOOKUP, not XLOOKUP, in order to return late, present, present. That's what we're looking for. So at the start of this, we'll use VLOOKUP. What are we looking for? Well, we're looking for the date. The date is in D1. I'm going to put a comma and then come back to D1 and put a dollar sign before the 1 in D1. That means as this is copied down, then D1 doesn't change, but we can copy this across. So this is saying we're looking for the 10th of July, 2023. And where are we looking for that? Well, we're looking for that in form responses, in this section here, in this list of dates. Let's use B2 to whatever the last column is. In this case, we'll go with AC. This is what index it's looking for. So how many across? This will be column 1, column 2, column 3, which is why we'll return the right status for the right person. Then after that, we'll put a comma and a zero. Press Enter, and we get all of the lates and presents. So we have late, present, 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 and then Mark is late. So if we look across here, we should see Mark being late, There's Mark, and he's late on this date. Serena is absent on this date, exactly what we see here. Now we can go one step further and change this VLOOKUP, this part in here, from D1 to D1 to J1. Press enter, and we get a whole bunch of NAs. Now the NAs just mean that this is not found within our VLOOKUP. So let's go to the beginning and start with an IFNA. Press enter, and they all disappear. So now if we enter more attendance, let's go to the eyeball in the forms. Let's put in the 11th of July. Let's go period 1 again. We can do our attendance. Click submit. And then straight away, we should see that right there. Presents and lates. We have David, Sarah, and Mark all late. And if we look on here, David, Sarah, and Mark all late. Perfect. Now we've got the basics of being able to pull up attendance records within seconds instead of wasting precious time digging through stacks of paper. But I know most of you are busy in your main jobs as teachers, administrators, community leaders, and spreadsheets can get difficult quite quickly. So I've got the thing just for you. If you are a complete beginner in Google Sheets, I've created a course that not only teaches you the basics of how to use this program, but the basics of the Google Suite. Just find the link down in the description along with the code to give you 20% off and join our community of spreadsheet learners. Now let's jump back into the spreadsheet to see how we can make it a bit more user-friendly and how to implement those periods or classes we set up earlier for our analysis. We don't need all of these rows or columns at the end. So let's get rid of those. We'll go View, Show, Grid Lines. Let's turn this into an alternating colors. And let's add in a few rows up above. Insert 5 rows above. That's way too big. And the header has moved as well. We'll double click that. Let's change our alternate formatting. And make sure that the range is, what is it, A6 to J26. Close that down, and now we can put in here the date that we want, and we can select this date by double-clicking it and changing it how we want. And what I want to show in here is the Monday of the week that includes the date that we pick. So in here, in our sequence formula, let's take this information, we'll delete it, click on C2 minus weekday C2 comma 3. Press enter. And that's going to stay as the Monday of the week that includes this date. So if we change this to today, the 11th, that's still going to be the right Monday. If we change it to the next week, then that changes to the 17th of July. So whatever date we put in here, we'll get the right week here. Now these words here, late, present, absent, they're a little bit too long. So how about we shorten them with a little bit of an abbreviation? So if we click on the first one and we go just before the VLOOKUP, let's use the left function. So we just type in left with a bracket, press enter, and we're good to go. Let's center everything. And that's exactly what we need. Now, if you're using periods, we can put the period or class, whatever you want to call it, below the date. In this case, we're using period 1. And now it's going to get even more complex. In our formula down here, in this D6 to J6, let's finish that off with an ampersand and C3. So that's going to be the 10th of July 2023 with the number 1 after it. Now we have to change this part. This is where it gets quite a bit more complicated. We'll start that off with a curly bracket. Now this curly bracket signifies to Google Sheets that we're creating what's called an array literal. We're going to create an array from a bunch of other cells. So let's start off with copying this part here. The form response is 1, B2, and then the colon. We'll copy that with Control C, and then after that, I'm just going to put a few spaces to separate the individual bits. We'll put a dollar sign and a B. Then we'll use an ampersand. We'll use Control V to paste in the same thing we had before, except change this B to a C. We'll use after that a dollar sign C, and then a comma. Let's paste in again the form response is 1, but this time this B, let's change it to a D. Delete all the spaces before that AC, so it looks like this. Form response is 1, D2 to AC, and after that we'll put a curly bracket. This section is our array literal. If we press enter, nothing happens down here because we're getting the exact same results. Hold up a moment, did you just see that? Let's rewind a bit. If we press enter, nothing happens down here because we're getting the exact same results. So when we added this new formula, the entire row shifted up one. I didn't notice it at the time that I was doing this, but I do notice it later on. So there is an error right here right now, but it gets fixed later. So keep watching. And we can see on the 11th of July, period two, we have all of this information. Just like before, we'll pretty this up just a bit. And now I can go ahead, enter some extra attendance, and let's see what the final result looks like. So I've gone through, added a whole bunch of data, and another thing we can do is up the top, you can see these darker lines here. If we mouse over this dark line so the hand appears, we can click on that and drag it down. That way we can scroll down each of our students without this information changing. Now, as you can see over in the form responses, I've got a whole bunch of data here. So as we change the date in here, we could change it to the 10th, but nothing changes because it's the same week that we had before. So what we could do is change it to last week, and there's our new data. We could also change the period from 3 to 4 to 5 and so on. If we try 6, there is no data because there's no 6 periods. So let's change it to 5, and we can actually change this to a drop-down list. So if we type at drop-down, we can click on that and put in our options. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and click on done. I don't actually like that being a chip, so let's go back in. Right down the bottom we have advanced options, and let's change that to an error. Click on done, close that, and now we can change this to any one of those 5. Let's change this back to period 1 for this week. Now let's use some conditional formatting so we can see at a glance when someone's present, late, or absent. So in our data set, we'll click on this one here, which is an E7, go up to the top with format, conditional formatting, and we'll change that to text is exactly, and in this case, let's call it P for present. We'll click the apply to range and change that to E7 to K. And then when we click off that, we can see all of the P's turn green. Let's scroll down, add another rule. Text is exactly L for late. We'll change that to a yellow. Click on add another rule, and text is exactly A for absent. Click on the fill button, change it to red, and click done. And now we can see straight away what the status of the student was on that particular day. Now just notice Mark Brown down the bottom here isn't shown in this set when he is being shown in this set. So let's just see if Emily Smith really is late on this date and this period, the 11th of July, period 3. I'm just going to freeze this. Go down to the 11th of July, period 3, and we can see that Emily is present instead of late. So it looks like everyone's offset by 1. So let's just go into here. We'll change this match here to minus 1. And there we go. If we change it to minus 2, we'll definitely see if that was right, because we end up with 4s here. Now this 4 corresponds to this number here. So let's change that back to minus 1. And we can see Michael Johnson on the 10th of July was late. Michael Johnson, 10th of July, was late. On the 11th of July, period 3, that's this one here, it's Renee that's late. And on the 11th, period 3, it's Renee that's late. So now we can see everything's working. We can do a few more tests just to double check. So let's change this to a different date. And let's look for Francois Taylor because he's got a good range of attendance statuses. So for the week, that includes the 4th of July, and we're looking only at period 3, we should see present, late, late, present, present, absent, present, just for Francois Taylor. So in here, we could filter this for period 3, click OK, and we're only looking at Francois, who is right here. And from the 3rd of July, we get present, late, late. From the 3rd of July, that's this one, present, late, late, present, present, absent, present, exactly what we see here. Let's clear that filter, we don't need it. And now you can continue using this daily attendance form over and over and over for the rest of the year, and then send off your daily attendance, this sheet here, off to your administration or however you use it in your classroom. Now, this method has some improvements over the QR system. First off, with the QR system, not everyone has a phone, and it can be difficult giving everyone a student ID card with their QR code on it. So this just eliminates that completely. You, at the front of the class, can call out the role just as you traditionally would on paper, but in this case, it's now computerized. You can do it directly from the Google Form, which also works on your phone. It's super quick. You don't even have to disturb the kids while they're working. Give them a starter, you do the role. By the time you're finished with the role, you can go over the starter. And if you missed out on the QR attendance and you want to get started on that, click this link here. And if you want to try a very engaging new attendance system, click on this link here. That's it from me. See you next time.